Next, Executive Vice President and Executive Officer Yoshiaki Tokunaga will make a presentation on digital systems and services sector. I will switch the screen, so please hold on for a minute or so. Thank you. Over to you, Tokunaga-san. I'm Tokunaga. Thank you very much for your time, taking time out of your very busy schedule. I will explain the growth strategy of digital systems and services sector, or DSS sector for short. First, I would like to summarize what I would like to share with you today. The first is the basic policy of the Midterm Management Plan 2024. By fiscal 2021, the DSS sector has evolved into a highly profitable entity and prepared for growth. Based on this effort in the Midterm Management Plan 2024, we aim to achieve revenue expansions and improve profitability. We will continue to provide value and achieve sustainable growth of Rumada as a partner to solve the problem of our customers in Japan and overseas. Second is the sustainable growth of Global Logic. Global Logic, which we acquired last July, continues to grow steadily and exceeded our plan in fiscal year 2021. In MTMP 2024, we will further expand synergies with Hitachi Group to achieve continuous business growth and enhance corporate value. Mr. Shashank, CEO of Global Logic, will explain more about Global Logic later. Third, Hitachi Digital will accelerate the Lumada business. Established in April, Hitachi Digital will lead the formulations and executions of digital strategy across the Hitachi Group under the leadership of CEO Taniguchi, serving as a central center. This will maximize the value at Hitachi strengths, combining OT, IT, and product, and accelerate the expansions of the Lumada business across the global Hitachi group. Fourth, we will invest in growth through cash generation. In MTMP 2024, we will strengthen our ability to generate cash and invest the resources and capabilities needed to expand Lumada business through growth investment, including M&A. Here is what I will explain today. I will begin with the overview of the DSS sector. The first is the business divisions of DSS sector. The DSS sector will combine the digital power of its three business groups, front business, IT services and platform, and collaborate with green energy and mobility, connective industry sector, and Hitachi Astemo to contribute to the realization of a sustainable society by promoting DX for customers' business operations and social infrastructures. This is the business structure. The DSS sector has a total of 100,000 employees operating in 50 countries and regions. We established Hitachi Digital in North America this year to strengthen the structure for formulating and executing global company-wide digital strategy. CEO Taniguchi, who's up on the stage today, leads the formulations and executions of digital strategy across the Hitachi group from Silicon Valley at the control center of Lumada business. In addition, from this year, we have established three business group systems by adding IT services centered on Hitachi systems and Hitachi solutions to the existing front office business and services and platforms. In MTMP 2024, under the business structure that I have just explained, we will disclose the business result and operations of DDS more transparently in an easy-to-understand way. This slide shows an overview of the business unit and major group companies in the DSS sector. Due to the time constraints, I omit the explanations and hope you will take a look at it later. This slide shows the positions of the DSS sector in the Hitachi Group's corporate result for fiscal 2021, as well as the compositions of revenues and adjusted operating income within the sector. The DSS sector accounts for 20% of Hitachi Group's total revenue and 36% of adjusted operating income. In addition, three business groups account for almost one-third each of the revenue and profit compositions within the sector. Next, I will explain the policies and performance target of MTMP 2024. First, let me discuss the business environment surrounding the DDS sector. Customers continue to intensify the use of digital and services to address increasingly complex business challenges. They are also accelerating the move against the environmental issues and SDGs. As a result, as shown in the graph on the right, the global DX market targeted by Lumada Business is expected to continue to grow by double digit in all the regions. We recognize that the business opportunity in the DSS sector is very large. Next is the basic policy of the MTMP 2024. The DSS sector has been strengthening its earnings power and solidifying its foundations for growth through the two mid-term plan of 2018 and 2021. In the MTMP 2018, we achieved a double-digit operating income margin by improving the adjusted operating income margin by 4.2% compared to fiscal 2015 by reforming our business portfolio, reducing loss cost, and thoroughly making an improvement. In MTMP 2021, we strengthened the foundations of Lumada's growth by acquiring Global Logics, launching the new Hitachi Ventura, and launching the Lumada Alliance Program. In MTMP 2024, we aim to reap the fruits of our efforts to date and achieve dramatic growth of the Lumada business in the global DX market. This is the performance target of the DSS sector in MTMP 2024. First, the revenue, the important indicator for growth. Regarding Lumada business, which is being focused by the entire Hitachi, we plan to outperform the growth of DX market and to achieve revenue of 2.6 trillion yen in DSS sector in fiscal 2024. We recognize that adjusted EBITDA ratio, a profitability indicator, is already one of the highest in Japan as of the end of fiscal 2021, and we aim to further improve it to reach 15% by FY 2024, which is on par with the global players. In addition, we will thoroughly implement cash-oriented management, generate EBITDA of over 1 trillion yen over the next 3 years, and continue to invest in growth. Next, I will discuss growth strategy to achieve MTMP 2024 targets. Here is the overall picture of the DSS sector growth strategy in MTMP 2024. We will implement the four growth strategies shown here to achieve rapid growth of Lumada business in the global DX market. In order to ensure the executions of these strategies, we plan to improve a total of 500 billion yen in M&A and other business expansions investment, as well as 200 billion yen in Lumada development investment and for growth within MTMP 2024 period. I will now provide the overview of each strategy. First, strategy one. In the growth model of the social innovations business by Lumada shown this figure, the DSS sector is the core business unit driving digital engineering, system integrations, and managed service. In MTMP 2024, digital engineering capability of the Global Logic, which newly joined Hitachi Group and combined Hitachi's OT, IT, and product to promote solutions to customer and social issues. We will also enhance our engagement with customers through these efforts, continuously create value for customers as a DX partner, and achieve sustainable growth for Lumada business. In other words, we will be rolling out the recurring business. Next, strategy two. One of the important features of the Lumada business is its scale of business. DSS sector will accelerate the scale of the Lumada business through three approaches. The first is the customer DX type. This approach is to increase engagement with individual customers through co-creations and to obtain repeat orders. This is an approach that the financial institutions and business unit and social infrastructure system business unit excels at. Next is the domains DX type. This approach is to develop new customers by horizontally deploying original solutions developed through co-creations with customers and solutions that have already been proven in the market. This is an area where the strengths of Hitachi systems and Hitachi solutions, which have a proven track record in the development of solutions and services, can be utilized. The last is the social infrastructure DX. DG type. This is an approach that builds a new ecosystem with many stakeholders to solve complex issues that cannot be solved by customers and Hitachi alone. This is a business that only Hitachi, which with its strength in OT, IT, and product can offer, and one that will actively pursue in the future. Let me now introduce some specific examples of Lumada business based on the market approach I have just described to explain to you about the growth and evolutions of first customer DX type. On the left is an example where the financial institutions business unit provided CMOS annealing quasi quantum computer to Sompo Japan and contributed to the reductions of the business risks in the insurance underwriting operations. We are also working with Sompo Japan on the development of various new services through co-creations, such as influenza and other infectious disease forecasting and corporate and SX support. On the right-hand side is an example of co-creations with BMW Group. Hitachi Ventura provides various data analysis and Global Logic provides design and engineering support for connected cars and contributing to BMW Group's innovation. Next is a domain DX type example. Hitachi Systems Ad World, shown on the left, has been adopted by more than 700 municipalities, contributing to municipals DX by improving resident services and administrative efficiency. In addition, Shibuya Ward has been promoting 100% electronic approval through a complete renewal of its ICT infrastructure to reform the work style of its employees. This has resulted in a 40% reduction in paper use. Hitachi Solutions Point Infinity, shown on the right, has been adopted by customers in a wide range of industries that built point a system, including convenience stores such as Family Mart. The total numbers of members in Japan and overseas has already exceeded 300 million users, boasting wonderful track record. Next is an example of social infrastructure DXGX. Let me first introduce a case here in Japan. As shown on the left, Social Infrastructure System Business Unit provides solutions to the social issues of aging social infrastructure facilities and decreasing the numbers of experienced maintenance workers by upgrading maintenance through remote inspections and image diagnosis using drones. Through open innovations with infrastructure operations, facility maintenance companies, and universities, the BU will realize more efficient infrastructure management and cost optimizations. On the right is an example of sustainable finance platform being promoted by Financial Institutions Business Unit to promote the collections and use of ESG data. By creating a new ecosystem connecting financial institutions and operating companies, we are working to enhance the sophistication of corporate ESG management and improve transparency toward the capital market. Here are some examples from overseas. On the left is an example of Optimize Prime, a consortium supporting the expansions of EVs in the UK as a measure against climate change. Hitachi Ventura led the consortium activities together with UK Power Network, the UK's electricity distribution company, to promote large-scale demonstrations projects that included the optimal placement of charging facilities and demand peak control. To the right is the Lumada Inspections Insight, which was announced late last month. Lumada Inspections Insight uses a proprietary AI image analysis technology to analyze data from satellite images and LiDAR to detect incidents at an early stage and reduce the risk of large-scale forest fires. Next is Strategy 3. Hitachi Digital, which was established in April, is to lead the development and execution of the digital strategy across the Hitachi Group as a central command of Lumada business. Specifically, Taniguchi, CEO of Hitachi Digital, will lead the company at Silicon Valley, the leading edge of digital, and will work closely with Hitachi Vantara and Global Logic, as well as OT sector, including Hitachi Energy, Hitachi Rail, and JR Automations, to strongly drive formations and executions of Lumada strategy. Toward the growth of Lumada business, Hitachi Digital will also play an important role in identifying necessary growth investment and lead their executions. In MTMP 2024, we plan to concentrate our investment in the areas shown here. Finally, strategy four. The key to expanding the Lumada business is to strengthen and expand digital talents. Global Logic has an excellent scheme in this area. In addition to continuously evolving the scheme, we will roll it out here in Japan as well. By expanding the mutual exchange of talents between DSS sector and Global Logic, we will strongly promote strengthening and expansions of the digital talents. The progress of these growth strategies I have just explained will be continuously followed by four KPIs. The first is the revenues at Global Logic, which represent the growth of Lumada business. The second is the ratio of Lumada service business, which indicates the customer engagement and business continuity. The third is revenues of overseas, which indicates the globalizations of Lumada business. The fourth is the revenue of whole Lumada business driven by DSS sector. We will closely monitor these four KPIs in order to achieve MTMP 2024. From this point onwards, Sheshank, CEO of Global Logic, will now discuss the Global Logic's overview as well as its growth strategy.
Thank you very much, Tokunaga-san.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Sheshank Samant, the President and CEO of Global Logic, and I'm very happy to be here with you today. Global Logic is the digital engineering services wing of Hitachi. We partner with the world's leading brands, Fortune 1000 companies, to help them see their digital world the way it is today, it should be, and not the way it is today. In such, we build amazing products, connected platforms, and engaging and intuitive experiences, net digitally transforming our clients' business. How we do that? We bring design creativity, engineering depth and experience, and data science together to make it happen. Next slide, please. We are engineers and we love to quantify everything, especially the success. And here are the numbers of our business in those quantification. We serve over 500 clients globally, of which 60% of the business is with Fortune 1000. In fiscal 21, we clock 1.28 billion USD revenue at 38% year-on-year growth. And the growth is at a very healthy margin, 23% EBITDA. As we make our clients successful in their digital quest, it is also benefiting Global Logic. Global Logic is the magnet for the best talent around the world. We deliver the scale of digital transformation with 9 design studios, 38 engineering labs, and 2 data science hubs, totaling to 25,000 plus employees in 14 countries. And with our growth, these numbers are just getting outdated as we speak. Next slide, please. Digital transformation magic happens when the physical and the virtual world come together, physical being the operating technologies and virtual being the digital technologies. To make it happen, you need design, engineering, and data prowess to come together. Design challenges the status quo and gives us the art of possible, which means envisioning the more and intuitive and engaging customer experiences as a service business and services models and redrawing the supply chains for our clients. Further, deep and complex engineering makes it feasible. It brings the experiences and solutions to life, and then data makes it more intuitive and actionable, making business viable through the insights. Bringing these very different disciplines together and hum like a music symphony is the Global Logic secret sauce. Next slide, please. Marrying with Hitachi to create the digital synergy is all about accelerating Hitachi's Lumada flywheel. Global Logic serves the key industries that are both disruptive and getting disrupted. Disruptive are the blue balloons over there, which are the high digital engineering services demand industries, which are listed over there, and disrupted are the one which are asset-heavy industries like the Hitachi's energy, rail, and industrial, who want to disrupt the business model as a service way, and those are the red balloons. These sectors have a high demand for digital solutions and create tremendous headroom for growth for all of us. The life cycle for digital transformation starts with ideation, followed by the engineering and build, then the integration, and then the runoffs, which are running the businesses or ongoing operations. At the heart of this digital life cycle is Lumada, to capture the enabling digital assets to power that life cycle, making the life cycle faster, drive the cost of build and TCO, total cost of ownership for the clients lower, and also to build and nurture cross-industry and cross-technology use cases, which means that capturing, cataloging, and cultivating the tools, methodologies, and use cases leading to the solutions, repeatable solutions. As you can see, GlobalLogic fits in perfectly well in the broader Hitachi Lumada ecosystem. Next slide, please. A tangible example is a recent solution we reimagine and develop in partnering with Hitachi Energy. APM, Asset Performance Management, is the solution. As you can see here in the chart, GlobalLogic utilized our own design studios to reimagine the Asset Performance Management, APM business case, and then our deep engineering and data practice to deliver the Hitachi Energy's Fortune 500 client. And such is being commissioned and managed by Hitachi Ventara in the field as we speak. Next slide, please. So how are we managing growth? Traditionally, GlobalLogic is always strong with American clientele. Almost 60% of our revenue is accounted in Americas. And we had high ambitions supported by our Europe growth, which is 30% of our business. Europe is getting further accelerated by Hitachi's BUs like energy and rail, which have a sizable presence over there. In less than a year since our acquisition, we have also established our presence in Japan and are seeing great traction on early engagements with Hitachi clients in Japan. To support our all these growth aspirations, we are aggressively expanding our delivery footprint in Europe, in Americas, and APAC. APAC is largely driven by India and Japan. In closing, I would say, as you have gathered by now, GlobalLogic is on an aggressive growth trajectory, largely driven by global digital demand, geographic expansion, and fueled by Hitachi partnership. Being part of the Hitachi family has enabled us not only to accelerate our own standalone growth strategy, but also find significant new opportunities in transforming Hitachi and Hitachi's clients. Thank you for your time. At this point, I will turn it back to Tokunaga-san.
Shashank-san, ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much, Shashank-san. We will now proceed to Tokunaga-san once again. Tokunaga-san, over to you. This is the summary for today. DSX sector will dramatically expand our Lumada business in the high-growth DX market and aim to become a world-leading company in growth and profitability by 2024. Our goal is to become a global leader in social infrastructure, DX, and realize sustainability, sustainable growth. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Thank you, Tokunaga-san. We now will entertain the questions from the floor. I will switch the screen. Please hold on. Joining Tokunaga-san to answer to the questions is Vice President and Executive Officer, CEO of Hitachi Digital, Jun Taniguchi, and CFO Digital Systems and Services Divisions, Masashi Hatakeyama. Those of you who have questions, please utilize raise hand functions, utilizing the Zoom functions. Of those raise the hand, I will call upon you, and please unmute and identify yourself with name and affiliations and state your questions. I will call upon the name which is shown on the screen. If no longer needs to raise a question, and please cancel your question. Your video won't be shown. We will first entertain the questions from those in the Japanese channel, followed by those in the English channel. Well, then, I will now entertain the questions and those joining us in the Japanese channel. Yasui-san, and please unmute the microphone and raise your questions in Japanese, please.
Thank you. UBS Securities, Yasui is my name. I have two questions. My first question, it's been a while after integrating Global Logic. Post-merger integration to retain the talent in that front, there might be some turnover, some people leaving the company. So inclusive of the fusions and integrations of the business, Shang-san and Tokunaga-san, please comment on the changes to the personnel, the talent. Second, CEO Kojima has talked about the Global Logic, which is good at recruitment. They do have a wonderful know-how in acquiring the talent, which shall be applied here in Japan more. Now, digital engineering seems to be a very interesting business. I hope that you will firmly establish the positions here in Japan. So from Japan, from the viewpoint of Shashank and Mr. Tokunaga, what are the opportunities both in Japan as well as in the overseas market? Those are my two questions. Yasui-san, thank you very much for your question. Both of the questions, first of all, let me comment first and then invite Shashank to provide some supplementary comment. First of all, the first point, now that we have integrated with the Global Logic, what is the status of PMI? In a nutshell, before what we assume in acquisitions, it's going well, very well. That's what I honestly feel. Let me give the specific example, level one leadership. Within the leadership team, after integration, and those there was no one leaving the Global Logic. So same leadership remains compared to the pre-integrations. And they are extremely happy now that they can work for Hitachi. So we are now working together. Now, how about the lower level talent as well as the status of integrations? We are showing a good progress. From Japan to Global Logic office, we are sending a lot of talent, Shashank and other leadership team. At this moment, they are working together. So that's my response to your first questions. Now moving on to the second questions. Recruitment functions of the Global Logic as well as positioning here in the Japanese market, as you have rightly pointed out, Global Logic, when it comes to global recruitment as well as the providing training and education, is one of the strengths that Global Logic has. I believe at the end of March, when we announced integrations at the March of the previous year, there's about 20,000 personnel working for Global Logic, and it's now reached 25,000. So in that sense, hiring has been progressing smoothly, as well as we are fostering highly capable talent. And this approach will be rolled out here in Japan. At the same time, Global Logic Japan it shall be the basis for us to do the digital engineering as well as to provide it to the Japanese customers. Shashank, please provide us with the supplementary comments.
Thank you, Tokunaga-san. I think you answered it very well. Since the time we actually merged the companies, July 2nd week, we do not have any attrition on the executive management or the senior management of the company. To the extent, our overall attrition of the company is running almost 700 to 800 basis points lower than our competition. And our attrition actually also came down. Our engagement, employee engagement score, the surveys which we run internally, are actually running at higher, 80 plus for the overall company. And I give a lot of this credit to the even Hitachi senior management who got actively engaged in explaining the employees the rationale and also showing that collectively what we can do together and of which the success already happening on that particular front. So both actually our inside surveys as well as the surveys on the Glassdoor and others all point out in the one direction, that is this merger is highly successful, not just for our clients, but also for our employees. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
We will take another question from the Japanese channel. Hiroi-san, please. Hiroi-san? Question. I have a question for Tokunaga-san. I have two questions. The first question is a confirmation. Regarding KPI, you said the Lumada service ratio is presented. What does this mean? Please elaborate further. In the presentation, you talked about the recurring. I believe it is these two are related. Please confirm this. Second question is regarding 500 billion, the investment that you are making. What is the substance of this? Global Logic has been acquired. This was a major acquisition. And as promoting Lumada, are you going to supplement what is required? So what kind of areas are you intending to invest in? So that's all in terms of my question. Answer. Thank you for your question. Those two points you mentioned are both very important. To your first point, regarding the service business ratio in KPI, as you have rightly pointed out, recurring ratio is what we mean by this. To elaborate further, in the Lumada growth model, we want to make sure that Hitachi can create business from all areas. That is our strength. And in this context, one KPI is Global Logic sales profitability. This is a growth KPI for us. It is because customer challenges are understood. And by Global Logic creating business, which will mean that SI, system engineering and services, will also benefit from this growth. So this is a KPI. This is the first one, the KPI for growth. The second one is Lumada service ratio. This is more recurring basis. What is the continuation of the business with our customers is reflected in this KPI. Therefore, the Lumada's benefit to be evaluated by the customer so that they will continue to engage with Hitachi. That is an important KPI for this purpose. Now, to your second question, 500 billion, the investment for growth has been included. And as I have mentioned, as Hiroi-san, you have mentioned that it is not just one investment that we are considering. It is going to be utilized for multiple investments in order to promote Lumada further. Strategy 3 is Hitachi Digital, a strategy I mentioned here, that at the very bottom of the slide, the various domains where we are considering investment has been outlined. As Hiroi-san, you have mentioned, Global Logic capability enhancement is one area that we'll focus on. Geographical footprint, as well as expansion into a new domain. In order to support Global Logic, bolt-on investment is being considered. The second KPI is the service enhancement for the cloud and managed services. Enhancement will be the focus for M&A, inorganic growth, in order to enhance our capabilities. That is what we are contemplating today. So these are the two areas of investment for us, to the tune of 500 billion yen. Investment for growth is being considered. That is all.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you. Thank you. I see more hands. I'm from the Japanese channel, so let me continue. Harada-san. Harada-san. Please raise your question. This is Harada. Do you hear my voice? Thank you. I have two questions. One, page 20, as is shown on page 20. Moving forward, your OT area, as well as the product, as well as how to liaise these two areas, will become very important. At this point in time, my impressions is that synergy can be generated from the field of energy. So I would like to confirm of the domain as well as the timing. And also, at this point in time, there will be sensors attached to various product to collect information. So what will be the percentage of product that have the sensor? And how ready are you to start the business? So that's my first question. My next questions have to do about KPI. The KPI of Hitachi is shown. But on the other hand, as a global logic, what are the KPIs do you have? So that's my second question. On page 25, net retention ratio, EBITDA, maybe the KPIs you have. But once again, please talk about the global logics KPI. Harada-san, thank you very much for your question. Now, on the first point, let me make some comment. And then Taniguchi will provide you with some supplementary comment. And then regarding the second question, Shashank will talk about the specifics of the KPI of the global logics. Now, about liaising with OT, as you have rightly pointed out, energy, in the field of energy, Hitachi Vantara, Global Logic, collaborations is going fairly smoothly, and specific asset performance and management development of solutions is already underway. Now, geographically speaking, DX market is rapidly expanding in North America. So North America is a very important market for us. So in that sense, in North America, rail, which have high presence, or the connective industries, partly the collaboration is underway. Take, for example, of the connected industries, compressor comes with sensors. So signs leading into diagnosis or to monitor the utilizations is now made available. How many centers, what shall be the coverage of the sensors? That is very difficult to respond because I don't have any information at hand, so I'm not in the position to respond right away. However, moving forward, to strengthen the product through digital, from that perspective, in almost all the product, in one way or the other, we would like to have the sensor being attached. And how we collect the data, sometimes on a real-time basis, sometimes on a bulk basis, there may be some different approaches, but we would like to utilize this also as to provide enhanced value to the customers. I believe that will be the very important point. Now, over to Taniguchi-san about the collaborations with OT. This is Taniguchi speaking. Can you hear me? Yes, we can hear you. Thank you. Now, about the first point, as you have rightly pointed out, in the field of energy, as Tokunaga has mentioned, there are already multiple projects underway, asset performance management. On top of that, energy, take for example, stability of the grid is another project that is already underway. Let me further specify. The renewable energy use is spreading. Then the balancing of energy is becoming more difficult and digital. Can make the adjustment and coordinations for the stable supply of energy. It has very high affinity with Global Logic or with Hitachi Vantara, these OT sector players. We have already started addressing that. That's one point. And similarly, as Tokunaga has mentioned earlier, rail industry, similar projects have already commenced. Let me cite some examples. Take, for example, industrial sectors products. Prior to my current positions, I was in the air conditioning as well as the home appliance business. Now, for the future product that we will be launching, it will become more connected. Now, this is related to your second question. Take, for example, elevators and escalators. To have more sophisticated and efficient maintenance, it's being highly connected. On the other hand, industrial products, for the future product to be launched, comes with the connected functionality. So it's still in the transitional phase. So in this area, performance will be enhanced over the air, for one thing, and also service subscription is a key. We will see further spread of a service and subscription service, particularly in North America. So Hitachi Digital shall serve as a control tower to give a positive influence within the Hitachi group. So that's what we are working on. This concludes my response.
Shashank, can you talk about KPI 2?
Tokunaga-san, Global Logic is a hyper-growth company, but we are not measuring Global Logic by standalone growth, but how we are actually working together with Hitachi to give that benefit to digitally transform the front views. So we are measuring Global Logic on Global Logic revenue growth. We are standalone revenue growth. We are measuring on the synergy business, which we can create along with Hitachi front views and along with their clients. We are at the same time, we are looking at net dollar retention rate that indicates essentially how many customers we have repeat business and how, as we are growing, can the growth sustain in terms of the commitment, multi-year commitment over the next few years. On the margin side, as I earlier said, if we are doing so good with our clients, that should also rub that success on our margins. So we are looking at EBITDA margin growth and EBITDA margin. And not the least, we are also checking on our attrition, how we are comparing against the industry. If you see across all these five parameters, we perform in fiscal 21 better than fiscal 20. So our quest is actually how to continue as we are hyper-growing, how that growth could be very secular, with the clientele which we have, how we can grow with them standalone as well as with Hitachi. And most importantly, our people are happy while doing so. And that is net creating actually the great EBITDA margin. So these are the five KPIs we follow very religiously. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That's very clear. Thank you. Thank you very much. There is also a question from Japanese channel, but we will take a question from the English channel at this time. Are there any questions on the English channel? Please press the raise hand button if you have any questions on the English channel. Boral-san, over to you. And please ask your question.
Okay, thank you very much for the opportunity. I am Bolar from Jefferies. I have two questions. My first question is to Mr. Tokunaga. Could you please share with us some examples of how the role of Hitachi's domestic IT business will change within the new medium-term plan versus the previous one? I'm assuming its role should expand in terms of collaborating with other business sectors and shift away from pure system integrator business model. Could you please share with us any action plans, operational changes you want to make to domestic DSS business? Thank you.
Hi, thank you very much for your question. As I explained earlier, up until the 2021 plan, DSS business has undergone a significant transformation. First point is that profitability is higher in terms of the business we pursue. With the acquisition of Global Logic, we have made the preparations poised for growth going forward. And as you have rightly mentioned, and as you have asked, domestic business will also undergo change. And it shows the direction for change in the domestic business. There are two points to be mentioned here. The conventional SI business will maintain profitability and further enhance the profitability. We must continue this objective. Going forward, there are many customers who have been engaging with Hitachi over the years. Mission critical system integration ability of Hitachi has been highly evaluated by our customers over the years. So we want to enhance this capability further going forward. The second point is DX business in Japan. We want to expand this further. Global Logic Japan has now been established. With this, the engineers in charge of Japanese business in the past have been given stimulus. They are feeling very much encouraged. And more than ever, we believe we can provide digital value to our customers in Japan as well. So there is a significant excitement for our business in Japan as well. The DX business expansion in the domestic market will be an important focus going forward. That's it for my response.
Thank you very much. My second question is to Mr. Shashank and Mr. Taniguchi. So to Mr. Shashank, it has been almost 1 year since GlobalLogic has been integrated into Hitachi Group. What are some of the new market opportunities and technological capabilities GlobalLogic has obtained to capture further growth just because of being part of Hitachi Group? From your presentation, I understand you mentioned energy and rail verticals. There are some synergies, and also APAC market is an opportunity. Any other synergies or technological capabilities? And in the same way to Mr. Taniguchi, what are the new business opportunities or technological capabilities? Some examples or changes happening at Hitachi Vantara now that GlobalLogic has joined?
Thank you for the question. After actually GlobalLogic merged with Hitachi, across three different vectors, we are getting benefited in terms of expanding our business. The first one is aligning our service lines with the firms which Hitachi has, which Hitachi Ventara. GlobalLogic traditionally is an ideation and engineering and trying to create the products and platforms and services, but we never operationalize that or try to run those systems in the market. Hitachi Ventara's capabilities in the cloud and running the systems is actually helping us to complete the value chain. And we won several deals, we bid on several deals, we won several deals from the marquee brands. And that is actually achieved in the first 6 months after we actually close the transaction. So number one is actually helping us to complete our service line, which is very important both to compete against the larger IT players, but also to offer the single point shop solution to our clients. On the second part of the lever, or the second axis, is the geographical expansion which GlobalLogic is doing. GlobalLogic is operating in 14 countries. With Hitachi, we are actually added almost close to 40 plus countries. And most important of that is Japan. It's a very large market for many of our core sectors like automotive, like communications and media, like banking and finance and retail and many other areas. And I'm very excited about it. Within 6 months after the acquisition happened, around month of March, we announced GlobalLogic Japan. And we actually, we seeded that entity from both Hitachi and GlobalLogic. And as we speak, you might have seen the announcement. We already announced actually our first contract within 9.5 weeks since the time actually we announced it with Nojima, which is one of the very famous brand in Japan. So we feel that both in the countries like Japan and some of the other countries in Western Europe, we are expanding our presence and offering our service to those areas. And last but not the least, which is most profound, is actually working with Hitachi Energy, Hitachi Rail, Hitachi Industrial, and Taniguchi-san himself is sitting over there, he is helping me in that particular line. These are the areas which are not the industry traditionally GlobalLogic dealt with. Or if we dealt with, on a very small scale. So we believe that both our design engineering and data, combining with Hitachi Ventara, we can offer the end-to-end solution to these industries. And last but not the least, all this comes together using Lumada. Lumada has over 1,000 plus business cases. And we just started exploring those business cases, trying to take those both horizontal and vertical, trying to take those to our clients and also enrich those business cases as we move forward. So you can see from my actually voice that I'm very excited. It's like a kid in the candy shop to a large extent in terms of what we can do. If 38% growth of GlobalLogic last year was one indicator, I think this is only the going supposed to go upward. Thank you.
Taniguchi-san, please supplement.
Well, then, from Taniguchi, let me also respond to your question. Conventional Hitachi's OT or Hitachi Vantara
Let me comment from the perspective. The newly acquired opportunity is what I would like to talk. As Shashank has mentioned, so this is similar to what Shashank has mentioned. Now, from the OT sector perspective, there are two things that we have acquired. One is the user experience, UX, or user interface, UI, based upon which the digital engineering. So new customers, business growth, as well as the opportunities toward that, and the utilizing the domain knowledge of OT, we can take up the challenge. In other words, to the customers, the new business opportunity can be now acquired. So that is one thing that we have acquired. Now, as a result, the way we conduct the business is now in the field of service. We've been making sales and the servitizations. The representative of that is the subscriptions. With working with a Global Logic, with Shashank, that is something that we have acquired. We will be acquiring, as well as this will further grow. Now, talking about Hitachi Vantara, as Shashank has already mentioned, our customers in the journey of DX, take for example with the new digital engineering of the digital logic, by concluding a contract, then his or her journey starts. But after that, in the business of the customers, it has to be steadily implemented and it has to continue the operation. That is also the necessary element, in other words, the service operations on the cloud. And this is the area where Hitachi Vantara have a strength. So from the eyes of the customers, the end-to-end a capability can be offered as a one-stop service. So this is the value for the customers as well as the newly acquired opportunity for us. So those are the two things that we have acquired compared to conventional Hitachi business. And now that we are working with Shashank and the Global Logic colleagues, so those are the opportunities that we have acquired. This concludes my response. Thank you very much.
Sorry, can I just confirm one additional question with Mr. Shashank, please?
Please.
Thank you. So you mentioned 1,000 plus business cases of Lumada solutions. Have you started actually offering some of them to your existing customers? And do you think there's enormous opportunities from this with minimal additional costs because there are already existing solutions?
Yes, yeah, so Lumada business cases come across both horizontal, which is around data, as well as the industries like automotive in which you operate. At this point, actually, as we are looking at it, as we are collaborating together and with Taniguchi-san, we are trying to figure out how to enrich these cases as well as how to take these cases and try to create solutions out of it. Oftentimes, business cases or use cases trying to solve a point problem. You need to get the multiple cases together and apply that to the service model in order to actually change, in order to make something digital to happen. So those are the areas. So it is this two-way solution. One is actually working on the engineering front to create the use case or use the use case, but at the same time is a design problem, how to apply that in trying to change or trying to modify how the customer is selling or customer is transacting, how to remove the friction in the digital side. So those are the areas. May just remind you, actually, we are just 9 months since the time we closed the transaction, or 10 months. So we just actually started that, but our early signs in terms of talking to the clients, creating the common clients and creating revenue out of that is very promising.
Okay, thank you very much.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much. The time has been completed for the digital system and the service sector. We would like to bring this session to a close. Thank you.